Hello everyone, good afternoon and welcome to this webinar by Merv Training and Consulting to introduce our latest tool offered to develop employees called the IDP Builder. So I hope everyone is having so far a great day. And if you are in the GCC region, then it's like 2 p.m. or 3 p.m. here. Some of you are getting for the weekend. If you are in Saudi, in Bahrain, in Oman, if you are in UAE, then the weekend is almost there with one more day to come. Thank you so much for joining this webinar. My name is Rabia and I'm going to be your host today, so I hope you're going to enjoy this conversation and in the same time be able to get some insights about how individual development plans are built and can be better built using technology. I just want to let everyone know that the webinar is recorded, so in case you would like later on to get to review it or watch it again, then the recording will be available on the YouTube channel of Merv Training and Consulting and on our website as well. So without further keeping you waiting, I would like to kickstart right away by quickly introducing the company. Merv Training and Consulting is a company that has been established in 1958 with a span of 66 years in the market, offering training and consulting solutions in the region within a lot of categories, a lot of portfolios, whether it is in project management and learning and development, and human resources and finance, and many, many more. The name of the company, for those of you who wonder where does Merv come from or how, for what it stands, it's an abbreviation for our five values: mastery, excellence, innovation, reliability, and client centricity, aiming always towards becoming your most trusted partner in developing excellence for generations to come. So the company offers nowadays training programs within a lot of categories, and most of these programs are certified and endorsed by international bodies, depending on the topic, to name few: the PMI for project management, the IIBA for business analysis, the ILM for leadership and management, and many, many more. About myself, my name is Rabia. I'm a partner with Merv Training and Consulting with an expertise in human resources, and I'll let you know a little bit more about myself as we go through this webinar. But part of offering this webinar comes from a career in talent development and L&D in the region. So to kickstart, I would like to define in the beginning what an IDP is. So definitely to choose joining this webinar, you are in the space of talent management, in the space of learning and development, in the space of human resources in a more or on a broader scope. And definitely IDP is an acronym that you know stands for Individual Development Plans. So what does it mean, an individual development plan? What does it consist of? So definitely it's a plan, as the name says, but at the end of the day, a plan is a document. And this document gathers in one place, in a structured way, all the learning activities that an employee needs to undertake in order to reach a career aspiration. So let's say you would like to be promoted to a manager, you would like to be a better performer in your place, you'd like to shift your career, you would like to move to another business unit, then this is the initiation of a development plan that will make you ready to reach to this career aspiration. So that's why the three sources that the IDP collate together are the following: the career aspiration, what would you like to, where would you like to see yourself progressing in your career? In order to progress, you need to define or at least to identify the competencies that you need to further develop in order to reach this career aspiration. And last but not least, you need to choose the learning activities that will develop those competencies and will make you reach the career aspiration. Definitely, many categories of employees need an IDP in the organization. Now, the most common practices for companies is to start asking people at managerial level and above to present their individual development plans in the beginning of the year and make sure later on that they commit to those individual development plans in order to develop themselves. So IDPs are tools for leadership development. More importantly, IDPs are also tools that high potential employees utilize in organizations in order to prepare for succession planning. So usually companies who would like to prepare the second line of managers usually prepare a pool of high potential employees. They call them successors, who will be ready to assume higher positions in the organization in case of departure of the people who are currently in those positions. But eventually, why not everyone having an IDP, their individual development plan? As a matter of fact, you can look at both ends of the spectrum. While high potential employees might be top performers, then in the same time, you can also ask poor performers to submit their IDPs in order to become better contributors in the organization. So these are mainly the target audiences that we can choose in the organization with which we would like to develop this kind of a development plan. Now, having said that, and if you come from practice with IDPs, I'm sure that you have faced two major challenges the minute you ask those people to submit their IDPs. So let's say this is end of December, beginning of January, you would like to prepare your training plan for the year. And part of this training plan is the development activities that your potential employees need to undertake is for your leaders to develop, or maybe for everyone in the organization, you need them to submit their IDPs in order to collect all these together and submit your training plan, get approval for your budgets, and get ahead with the implementation of the learning and development activities. You send this email to managers telling them, please, we would like to see you submitting IDPs within the next 2 weeks. And then you wait and wait, and few responses come. And then you'll have to follow up, and you'll have to beg, and you'll have to offer help, and you'll have to do the IDP on behalf of some people in order to get this project done. And it rarely gets done in 2 weeks. Usually it drags for a month or two. And by the end of these 2 months, not everyone submits their IDPs, despite all your efforts and despite all your selling abilities within the organization. So that's the first challenge. But within the challenge of time, there is also the time that building an IDP consumes from the target audience. So a manager would spend a good 4 to 5 hours within the span of this month in order to compile what they need to do, or what is the development they would like to undertake, or maybe what the development their team would love to undertake. But despite all this time and despite your follow-up and support, in most of the time, the output quality is not optimal. So you end up getting very basic development plans. And by basic, I mean two or three titles for common training workshops that someone needs to undertake. They are not focused, they are not elaborate. So you spend all this time and the outcome is a little bit, dare I say, frustrating. And you'll have to deal with whatever you got, because you cannot go again and tell those busy people that what you submitted is not what really, not really what we wanted to begin with. So I know that this is a struggle for most of us, but it shouldn't be anymore. I had this struggle in the corporate world when I used to work as head of talent development, when I used to handle learning and development activities with my previous employers, and whenever I was responsible for the career progression of high potential employees in organizations. So accordingly, I decided that I would like to automate this process. I would like to make it very fast. I would like to make it with a minimal to zero typing required. I would like to make it an enjoyable experience for the users while making sure that what I get at the end is a high quality IDP that both the employee and their manager is proud to present for human resources, and it would be a pleasant opportunity or a pleasant occasion for the HR people to receive, to read, and to use in order to compile their training plan. So what you are seeing on the screen is how the NERC IDP builder functions, how straightforward it is for the users in order to build their IDPs. So accordingly, unless you have any questions at this point, I would like to move to demonstrate to you how our platform is able to generate high quality IDPs very quickly with almost zero to minimal typing required. So if all is clear, no questions, I would like to proceed right away to the platform itself. All right, all good apparently. So let me show you how it works. So if you visit the Merck homepage and then you go to services, you will find the IDP builder link where you will be able to log in with either an admin credential or a user credential, depending on the setup. And once you log in, you can go to create report, and you can choose your career aspiration from the three options that you can see in front of you. So let's say I would like to advance to leadership. I can copy my yearly objective from the performance management system and add them here. So I'll, just for the sake of the example, I would say market the IDP builder in three different territories, close 25 deals with clients from the region, and get new leads for the IDP builder from new regions, just for the sake of the example. And then I press save and next. The platform will ask me, what is the competency that you would like to develop in order to reach this career aspiration and your objectives? So it will offer me three types of competencies. I'll choose first a leadership competency. And the platform itself will offer me a collection of leadership competencies. Let's say I would like to go with change management. Once I choose this competency, the platform will offer me a list of available courses related to this competency. Let's say I chose the Swiss Business School endorsed adaptive leadership tools and tactics. I go and I press add course. The platform will tell me the objectives of the course and will allow me to focus on those that are the most important for me. So I'll choose the objectives 2, 3, and 4. I'll add the course. Then I will choose the target month. But more importantly, we all know that attending the course itself is not enough to develop a competency. So after attending the course, the first step is to offer an evidence of knowledge acquisition. So the platform will give me the choice of choosing a test result maybe, so that will be a pass from the first time. But I would like also to share my knowledge with my colleagues, let's say, in a presentation. But I would as well love to submit a summary in October of 600 words to leave it as a leave behind document for others that would like to know what I learned from the workshop. That's going to be my knowledge acquisition evidence. After that, since change management is a behavioral competency, then it's not only about knowledge acquisition. In fact, it's about a change in behavior. So the platform is telling me, what is the behavior you would like to change? But it's not going to leave me without a drop-down menu of behaviors related to change management. So let's say I would say establishing a sense of urgency. But then the platform will tell me, this is too nice to be observed or too generic to be observed. What are the indicators that you will change in order to show that the behavior has been adapted? So from establishing a sense of urgency, it will offer me three change indicators, like, for example, explaining the risk of the status quo. And The platform will ask me who are going to be the witnesses of this change in your behavior. And those witnesses, let's say in this case, would be my peers. Finally, the platform will tell me, since it's a behavioral competency, do you need the help of a coach? So I might go and say, yes, I would like Jimmy Haddad, who is the deputy managing director in Merck, to offer me 5 coaching sessions that would be completed by December 2024. And I press finish. The platform now will ask me, would you like to add another course to the change management competency, or you would like to work on another competency? So let's say in this case, I would like to add a new competency, but this time I will choose a technical competency. And since my objectives are all about marketing, then I will go and choose marketing management as a technical competency. I press save, I add the course, and then it will offer me a myriad of available courses. So let's say since I have the objectives of exploring the opportunity of marketing IDP in new territories, I will go for the course of ISM endorsed strategic marketing plan. Then I'll choose the objectives I need to focus on. I'll go for December 2024. I'll save, but this time I will opt only for the test result. I will not choose all of them, and I will aim to score more than 90%. Now here, since the competency is technical, then the platform knows it cannot be done through behavioral change, but through projects. So I will choose a project that I will be working on next year, which is selling the IDP builder with a deadline to be in May 2025. A success indicator would be on specs delivery, and my assessor would be the direct manager. But in the same time, maybe I will need a mentor who will guide me through this project. So I will choose someone from inside our organization who's a partner in Merck, Mr. George Khayat, who is an expert in marketing. And then I will press finish. Then you will see that the platform again will ask me whether I would like to choose another competency to develop or another course. I'll just add another course to show you how it works. And as you can see this time, the ISM endorsed strategic marketing is not here because I chose it already. So let's say, for example, I will go for the marketing communication course. I'll choose all the objectives. I'll choose a target date to be in December, May 2025. I save. I would like this time only to submit a summary in June 2025 of more than 800 words. I'll opt out for the project since it's gonna be the same. Let's add it, you know why? Why not? The deadline, as we said before, it's, let's say, May 25. That's the same success indicator. That's the same. That's the same as you can see. Okay. The platform will offer me a completion. And that's it. So finally, I will add an interpersonal competency, which is as well behavioral, but usually is not for leaders. And let's say this time that I would like to work on maximizing my productivity in order to be able to juggle this project. So in terms of productivity, let's say I will choose a course called 5 Productivity Traits for Optimal Result. As you can see now, it's becoming more and more repetitive, which makes the user more familiar with the platform itself. I will do only a test result. And I will choose another behavior, which is, let's say it's time management. The indicator is prioritizing tasks according to highly important goals. And this time, the witness would be my direct manager. I will not choose a coach for this one. I'll finish and then I'll go to preview my report. So as you can see, I started building this elaborate report with all the explanation 10 minutes ago exactly. Definitely the platform will offer me a chance to edit if anything is not appropriate. But let's say everything is okay, only the idea that I would like to attend this workshop in June instead of July. I'll just go here, I'll save, and then my report will be ready. I'll press on create report, and you will see right away the beautiful document that the platform has built for me. So I'm gonna read some excerpts of the document. It's saying, as a result of my IDP this year, I aim towards getting promoted to a managerial position where I lead, develop, and inspire my colleagues. My objectives for this year are, and to reach my career aspiration, I'm following the below competency, the below plan of competency development, describing all the competencies I will develop. This year with all the learning activities associated with it. So it wrote this for me just to make sure that it's written properly and it's written nicely in the same time. So, sorry, it seems I clicked something by mistake. Can you still see the report now? Yes, okay, thank you, Mala. Excellent, excellent, very good. So then let's say I go to the change management. Notice how the text is neat, is proper, and is comprehensive. To develop the competency of change management, I am attending the SBS endorsed Adaptive Leadership Tools and Tactics course, or a similar one in September 24, after which I will be able to discover the implications of the status quo, create an adaptive culture by mobilizing the system, devise a plan to identify role priorities, prioritize and articulate their purposes in adaptive challenge. To ensure that I gained maximum, you remember we chose, I will pass from the first time. I will share my knowledge with my colleagues with 1 hour presentation in September, and I will submit a summary by October that would be available for my colleagues. After the course, I will show more establishing a sense of urgency through explaining the risk of status quo, and my peers will definitely notice this change in my behavior. Finally, developing the right behaviors of change management requires the support of a coach with whom I can discuss my challenges and alternatives. Accordingly, I'll schedule 5 sessions. There's a typo here, with Jimmy Haddad, the deputy managing director, who would support me in following an action plan to adapt such behaviors. The coaching process is expected to be done by December 2024. And then it goes the same for the marketing management, but this time it's explaining the project, which is selling the IDP builder, all right? And maximizing productivity all goes the same. Now that's the final output. It can be shared by WhatsApp. It can be shared by email. It can be downloaded as a PDF that I can save as a nice document in my station so I can refer to it. Now, moreover, when I go to my reports, I will have the opportunity to edit the report for a week. I can view my report, but in the same time, if I would like to present this report to someone who's very busy or who doesn't like to go into details, then I have a mini report that only describes the learning activities very quickly in a tabular format that I can share with someone by WhatsApp or by email as well. And it comes in a chronological order of learning activities that I encompassed within the report itself. Finally, I can go to my report, and throughout the year, as I progress to implementing those learning activities, I can go, notice here now the progress bar is at 0%. Now, if I press on attended the SBS endorsed adaptive leadership workshop, then it goes to 13%. If I passed the exam, then it's 20. If I started the coaching process, then it's 22, etc. If I attended the ISM endorsed strategic marketing plan and passed the result, if I started the project, then the progress bar is increasing accordingly. Now that's what happens from the user end. However, from the administrator end, who is, for example, the talent development manager, can see an analytics page with the total active users, how many didn't start yet their IDP development, who started the IDP, and how many users are done, completed their IDPs, and out of those 9 people, how many reached 0 to 25% in their progress, how many reached 26 to 50, 51 to 75, and 76 to 100. So that's how the platform operates. It's a registration-based service that we are offering right now at a promotional prices as well, and hoping that it will in the same time serve everyone as a effective tool to speed up the process of creating the IDP, and in the same time as a tool to help users develop IDPs that are more comprehensive, more learning based, and in the same time of very high quality. So that's what I had to say about the platform. I will also give everyone who is attending the seminar or the webinar a chance to ask questions about the platform and how it operates, should you have any questions related to this. All right, so John, thank you very much for this. In fact, the admin will have the nudge button to go and nudge users who started but did not finish yet, or those who did not yet start developing their IDPs. All right. So if no further questions, I hope, ladies and gentlemen, that you enjoyed this webinar. Oh, I have another question. Well, in fact, what is offered right now is the titles of the courses that Merck offers, because we have the structure of the courses with the objectives. But as you noticed, that the report itself says clearly that, share again the text itself, that it says clearly that it's discourse or a similar one, right? And for example, if you are looking for a course called Marketing Communication and Media Planning, this is a very generic title that could be offered by any organization. Now, on top of that, in case you have your own workshops that you would like to incorporate into the platform allows full customization depending on your corporate needs. Yeah, sure. So allow me please to drop down my email, okay? And if you don't mind, you can either establish, like, just send me a quick note by email so we can further understand the needs and come up with a tailored proposal to understand the budget. Or I can, if you allow me, to extract the email address that you registered with to the webinar, and I can initiate contact from my end. Mala, which option would you prefer? The platform, no, it's not calculated in the platform. So the registrations are sold by bundles. So the first 100 users are priced, and then if you have 101 to 200, then the price goes up another level, and etc. So it goes up by hundreds of users, and it's a 1 year registration. Sure. And by the way, Mala, because your question was about the IDP courses, you mean like you want the cost of implementing the development plan? That's what you mean? Oh, sorry, I misunderstood the question. I'm very sorry for that. No, in fact, it doesn't give you an estimated budget. It doesn't. All right. Further question, ladies and gentlemen? Okay. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure having you. I hope this webinar was beneficial. And as I said, I typed my email in the chat. Please feel free to get in touch in case you would like to get a more details about the solution, or why not, if you would like to get a demo user to try the platform, please feel free to reach out on the email that I typed on the chat. Now, with that said, I would like to wish everyone a great afternoon or a great remainder of the day. Thank you so much for your time, and bye-bye.